فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى today we're going to start an explanation on the book مختصر الخصال المكفرة written by الشيخ العلامة عبد الرحمن ابن أبي بكر ابن محمد السيوطي المصري الشافعي. الإمام السيوطي wrote this book, and inshallah ta'ala this is the book in which we will be explaining in this sit and this part بإذن الله الكريم. Before we go into the book, inshallah ta'ala there are مقدمات, introductions which I want to do. The first one being التعريف بالمصنف. The author of this book, who is he? And a bit about him, inshallah ta'ala. Then inshallah ta'ala, the second muqaddimah which I want to go through is an explanation, التعريف, an explanation بالمصنفي. The book in which we're going to be going through, a bit about it, inshallah ta'ala, regarding its naming. What is it dealing with? Why this particular book? And inshallah ta'ala, we will then go into the book. Bi'idhnillahi al-Kareem. The author of this book is none other than the great famous Imam, the great famous scholar that we all know of, Al-Imam al-Suyuti rahimahullah. His name is Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Bakr ibn Muhammad As-Suyuti al-Misri al-Shafi'i. He's an Egyptian. And he is one who ascribes himself to the Shafi'i madhab. Even that though Al-Imam al-Suyuti rahimahullah classified himself as a mujtahid. He has a book called Husn al-Muhadara where he speaks about his own biography. He wrote his own autobiography. He has his autobiography, rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'a. And he classified himself and categorized himself as to be a mujtahid. He believed he was a mujtahid. He didn't believe he was a muqallid. And at his time, the trials and the tribulations which he went through was that the people, as you know, taqlid, blind following, has become very prevalent. And due to that reason, he, rahimahullah, they didn't allow him to claim ijtihad. They wanted him to be just a blind follower of the Shafi'i madhab. So they wanted to demonize him, alienize him from the community and the people. And Al-Imam al-Suyuti rahimahullah, so they called out for a debate. And Imam al-Suyuti rahimahullah, when they called him out for a debate, he responded by saying to them, I consider myself to be a mujtahid, and you guys consider yourselves to be muqallideen, blind followers. And he said, a muqallid is not one who can debate. You can't debate with me if you're a muqallid. You have to debate with me as a mujtahid. Because a muqallid is a blind follower of a sheikh. And as Imam Ibn Abdul Barr brought in his kitab, Jam'u Bayan al-Ilmi wa Fadli, that the muqallid is never put in the category of the scholars. The muqallid is never brought in the realm of a scholar. Ibn Abdul Barr brings ijma' on this. And his kitab, Jam'u Bayan al-Ilmi wa Fadli. So they're in a predicament right now. And the predicament that they're in is, if they claim that they are mujtahideen, then the debate won't go forward because they came to what he came to, the conclusion he came to. So the debate won't go forward. And if they claim that they are muqallideen, then they would have to find somebody who's a mujtahid to debate Suyuti, or else the debate won't take place. He also has another book where he talks about his biography, which is At-Tahadduthu bi Ni'matillahi, talking about Allah's blessings on you. You know, from min babi qawli ta'ala fa'amma bi ni'mati rabbika fahaddith. You know, speaking about the blessings that Allah has bestowed upon you. So he talks about his life and what Allah has given him. You see, Al-Imam al-Suyuti rahimahullah. And he claims, Al-Imam al-Suyuti says that every teacher that had ever taught me, I became more knowledgeable than him in the particular field he taught me, the field that he knows. The sheikh, the shuyukh that I studied with, that I took knowledge from, Al-Imam al-Suyuti rahimahullah, he said, I became more knowledgeable than them in the books and the field which they taught me, except one scholar. Except who? Al-Imam Alamuddin al-Bulqayni. Alamuddin al-Bulqayni, which is the son, not the father. The father is Sarajuddin al-Bulqayni. And the reason I'm saying Bulqayni is the correct way of saying it, not Bulqini. Some people, they say Bulqayni, and it's mimma ishtahara ala al-sinati al-nas. The correct way of saying it is al-Bulqayni. Ala kulli hal, he's the only scholar, he said, that became more, who's more stronger than me in the field which he knows, which is Alamuddin al-Bulqayni knew fiqh better than me, he said. And Al-Imam al-Suyuti rahimahullah, he is an alim, a man who Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave him understanding and comprehension of the funoon of the sharia. Like, there's little a field you would find, except he has written a book in it. And from the greatest book that he has written, from the greatest book that Imam al-Suyuti rahimahullah wrote, is his book Al-Itqan fi Ulum al-Qur'an. This book, unprecedented. Haqiqat al-Amr. The reality of the matter is this book, Al-Itqan fi Ulum al-Qur'an, if a talib ilm, a student of knowledge, reads it after having taken the science from scholars and people of knowledge and studied it, and takes this book and studies this book, he will come out with a lot of benefits. And as you can see here right now, is Suyuti's life, what you can see from it is that, as I said, he's mutafannin. He knew fulun of the shaykh. He was good in hadith. He was good in tafsir. He was good in qira'at. He was good in fiqh. He was good in the language, and etc. What you can see from his life here right now is that this ideology that creeped into the Muslims later in life, or in the later stages, which is, I'm mutakhassis, I only specialize in this field, I won't speak about any other field. This is a bid'ah. This is an innovation. Na'am, a student of knowledge can later become talented in a particular field over the rest, but that doesn't mean he can't say, I can't speak about the others. He has to have understanding of the other sciences. He has to have some understanding. There is a particular field that you're going to enjoy more, a field that you're going to, inshallah ta'ala, indulge more into, but you don't do ihmal, you do not forsake the other field and have no understanding of it. Al-Imam al-Suyuti rahimahullah, he's called Suyuti nisbatan, is an attribution to ila Suyut, or you can say Asyut. Or you can even say Usyut. Naam. And it's a balda mashhura, it's a famous place fi Sa'idi Masra in Egypt. And I went there, I was there once. It's a place in Egypt. Wa yukna bi Abi al-Fadl. His kunya is Abu al-Fadl. Wa yulaqabu bi Jalaluddin. And his nickname is Jalaluddin. Sometimes the scholars, they summarize it, they shorten it by just saying Jalal. Al-Jalal. And what we know from the book that Al-Imam Bakr Abu Zayd rahimahullah Imam Bakr Abu Zayd, haqiqatan, was an alim. He wrote a book where he talks about these alqab and these kuna, these nicknames in which people give themselves, such as Jalaluddin, Taqiyuddin, Shihabuddin, these names. And he mentions that these names pull and push the minimum. أَقَلُّ أَحْوَالِهَا, the minimum it could be is what? Al-karaha, that is disliked. Al-al-al-aqal, the minimum. The reason of it being, it falls under لِمَا تَضَمَّنْهُ مِنَ التَّزْكِيَةِ. The person is praising himself. And this truth, the truth of this is that it really is something that didn't come from the Arabs. This wasn't something that Arabs used to have. It's something that came from the Ajam, the foreigners, those who are not Arabs. ثُمَّ دَبَّتْ فِي الْعَرَبِ. Then it creeped into the Arabs. Something that creeped into the Arabs later. Al-Imam al-Suyuti rahimahullah, he was born on a Sunday in the month of Rajab when the year was 849 Hijriya. 46 and 800. The Shaykh rahimahullah, he died on a Friday. At-tasi'ashara, 19th of Jumad al-Ula, when the year was 911. And how old would he be then? His age would be 61, right? 62. Yeah? 62. Al-Imam al-Suyuti rahimahullah, was said that he came to the gatherings of Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani as a kid, a very young kid. He saw Ibn Hajar. Rather, his father brought him to Ibn Hajar when he was born. And he asked Ibn Hajar to make dua for this young boy. And so Ibn Hajar made dua for Suyuti. Ibn Suyuti rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'a, was born in a maktaba. His mother gave birth to him in the maktaba because his father was a scholar. He was a man of knowledge. And he's from a house of knowledge. And his mother gave birth to him, as I said, in the maktaba. Rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'a. This book, what is the name of it? As I said, it's called Mukhtasar al-Khisal al-Mukaffira. That's the name mentioned by some of the muhaqqiqin, the mufahrisu, the scholars that placed naming of the book. This is the name they gave it. Some called it Talkhisul Khisal al Mukaffira, and also others called it Tajreedul Khisal al Mukaffira. And all three of those names, they're very good names, ala kulli hal. But it became very well known for the first name, Mukhtasarul Khisal al Mukaffira, as this was the name that it was published on. What does this particular book deal with? This book deals with the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that speak about speech and actions that a person can do, that he can come with, that will allow him or her for their previous sins to be expiated. In other words, it is actions or speeches, inshallah ta'ala, that if you come with, your previous actions and your upcoming actions will be expiated for you. This is what this book deals with. The way that the methodology of the author of this book is that Al-Imam al-Suyuti rahimahullah, he basically starts with, as we're going to see soon inshallah, is he's going to explain his intention, inshallah ta'ala, and what he plans to be doing here. Very small. And then he starts to go through the narrations. And there are 16 narrations, as we're going to see. Each narration indicating, as I said, speeches and actions that a person can come with that will what? That will allow them for their sins to be expiated for them. Their past sins and the upcoming sins. But what Imam al-Suyuti did not do was, he did not bring the ahadith with their chains. So he didn't do that. But instead what he did was, he brought forward the scholars who brought it in their books, بيان مخرجيها من الحفاظ المسندين. So if Imam Ibn Abi Shayba brought it in his Musannaf, he brings it. If Abu Awana brings it in his Sahih, he brings it. If you know Abu Dawood brought it, he mentions it like that. Instead of bringing the chains for it, he doesn't do that. And he also mentions the name of the companion. He mentioned the name of the companion. But what he did not do was, he did not mention, the daraja of the hadith. But what he did was, he sufficed himself with mentioning the name of the scholar who brought it out. So as I said, if Ibn Abi Shayba brings it in his Musannaf, or an Imam Abu Dawood, or Nasa'i, or Tirmidhi, or Abu Awanis Farayini Rahimullah, he just suffices himself with that. He doesn't go into what? He doesn't go into the Sanid and the chains. And what he also doesn't do is, he doesn't grade the narrations. He doesn't do that. This book, as you can see, is a muqtasar, it's a summary. And as he's going to tell us where he summarized it from. Before I go into that, there is just one point that I wanted to mention, which is al-mu'allafat fil mawdu'. There are books that are written in this field. Suyuti is not the first to do it. Or rather, he's not the last to do it as well. So there are scholars who've done it before him and after him. The scholars that had done it before him are many in number. And they gave it importance, just like he gave it importance right now by bringing the chains and the narrations for it. Others have also done the same. If, for example, you look at an Imam Abu Bakr Ahmad ibn Ali ibn Sa'id al-Maruzi, rahimahullah, he jama'a al-ahadith, he compiled all the ahadith al-mutadhamminatu lidhalika, all the narrations that are pertaining to this particular field, particular subject, he tried to bring all the narrations for it, or he brought some narrations for it. We're going to see later, inshallah ta'ala, Al-Imam Zakiyuddin Abdul Azim Al-Mundiri, the author of At-Targhib wa At-Tarhib. He also has a juz, a small compiled narrations, which is called Juz'an fi Ahadith Maghfirah, ma taqaddama wa ma ta'akhara min al-dhunub. He compiled it, Al-Imam Al-Mundiri. Also from the scholars who wrote it is Muhammad ibn Abdul Da'im ibn Salama, who is very well known as Bin Ibn Bint. He has a book called Al-Wujuh Al-Musfirah, عن تيسير أسباب المغفرة. Again, الإمام شهاب الدين أحمد بن علي بن حجر العسقلاني رحمه الله. He has a little رسالة like that as well, which is مطبوع. Which is مطبوع, it's published. And it's called معرفة الخصال المكفرة للذنوب المتقدمة والمؤخرة. He's published that. Also, Burhanuddin Ibrahim ibn Muhammad al-Naji al-Dimashqi has a risala, which he called it مَا تُغْفَرُ بِهِ الذُّنُوبِ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْهَا وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. This is مخطوط, it's not published yet, according to my knowledge. Al-Imam Jalaluddin al-Suyuti rahimahullah, he also has a nadhm of it. He has a nadhm of this particular subject. He has and it's matbu', it's published. Also, Jamaluddin Muhammad ibn Umar al-Yamani, he has it. It's called Al-Nubdhat al-Mukhtasar fi Ma'rifat al-Khisal al-Mukaffirat lil-Dhunub al-Muqaddamah wal-Mu'akhkhara. And others, there are roughly 17 scholars who've written in this particular field. And then it's something that the scholars, they gave it inayah, importance. So it's something, inshallah ta'ala, that we also want, because we want to come with actions that when we do bi-idhnillahi al-kareem, our past sins will be forgiven for us and the upcoming sins, inshallah ta'ala. The author, rahimahullah, he started by saying, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد فهذه رسالة لخصت فيها الخصال المكفرة للذنوب المتقدمة والمتأخرة. وقد ألف الحافظ ابن حجر كتابا سماه بالخصال المكفرة للذنوب المتقدمة والمتأخرة، وقد سبقه إلى ذلك الحافظ المنذري، وقد رأيت أن ألخص أحاديثه ليستفاد. He started the book by saying the basmala, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And this is something we say and we always mention, that starting with the basmala in books, in letters, is a sunnah qawliya and it's a sunnah fi'liya, right? Even that we said that the sunnah qawliya is what? Is da'if, is weak. The sunnah qawliya is weak. كُلُّ أَمْرٍ ذِيبَالٍ لَا يُبْدَأْ فِيهِ بِبِسْمِ اللَّهِ فَوَ أَبْتَرْ. Every action that the basmala is not started with is a disconnected act, is insufficient. We said that this hadith is weak. So it is weak qawlan, but it is sahih fi'lan. Meaning from the af'al of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is that he used to start his letters that he would send to leaders, he would start with the basmala, as he did عليه الصلاة والسلام in the letter which he sent to Hiriqil Azim al-Rum صلوات الله وسلام عليه. الحافظ ابن حجر العسقلاني in فتح الباري, which is the شرح صحيح البخاري, he mentions, because ابن حجر has an explanation on صحيح البخاري, and الإمام البخاري started his صحيح with what? The basmala. He didn't start with the hamdala. Bukhari started with the basmala. And Hafidh ibn Hajar mentions why Imam al-Bukhari started with the basmala and not the hamdala. The reason being, that's the sunnah of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. So, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most gracious. Alhamdu lillahi rabbil alameen. Hamd and praise is for what? For Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Wa salatu wa salamu. Salah, we took the qawl of Abu Aliya, which is that it means Abu Aliya al-Rayhi, what did he say? It is what? Thana'ullah, it is that Allah praises the Messenger fil mala'il a'la, in the high above. Al-Imam al-Bukhari brings it mu'allaqan bi sighatil jazm. Wassalamu means peace. Ala sayyidina, our master, meaning the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. You see, Sayyidina and then Muhammadin. And Muhammad is badal al Sayyidina. It's the same thing. Sayyidina is Muhammad. You see, ala Sayyidina, our master. And the Prophet said this, alayhi salatu wa ana Sayyidu waladi Adam, wala faqr. I am the master of the children of Adam. So our Prophet is the Sayyid, he's a master. Muhammadin, Muhammad. This master is who? Muhammad ibn Abdullah. Muhammad means the one who is praised a lot. The one who is what? He's praised a lot, alayhi salatu. And no doubt our Prophet is praised a lot. And the one who tries to belittle the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam, and belittle him, Allah told us in the Quran, Inna shani'aka huwa al-abtar. Inna shani'aka huwa al-abtar. The one that tries to belittle and insult the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam, that person is going to be disconnected. That person is going to be, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to destroy him. Allah is going to destroy that individual. لِذَلِكَ the Prophet ﷺ, when the Quraysh, at that time Quraysh used to have their form of media, pay attention here. Quraysh had their own media at the time of the Prophet ﷺ. Their media was what? Poetry. And that's how they used to get their information around. And they used to use that media to propagate the hate of the Prophet ﷺ. So it's nothing new today. So they would make poetries about the Messenger alayhi salatu against the Prophet alayhi salatu salam. وَلِذَلِكَ what did the Prophet respond to them at? What did he say to them? They are insulting a مُذَمَّمًا وَأَنَا مُحَمَّدٍ. The one that they are insulting is a مُذَمَّم, the one who is not praiseworthy. A person who is not praiseworthy. A person who is blameworthy. وَأَنَا مُحَمَّدٍ. The one they're insulting is not Muhammad. It's a مُذَمَّم, another one. لَأَنَّا أَنَا مُحَمَّدٍ. I am the one who's praised Allah, عليه الصلاة والسلام. So whatever they say about our Prophet, عليه الصلاة والسلام, we just have to remember that sab, that insult, and that name calling which you're saying, that's مُذَمَّم. That's one that's blameworthy. As for our Prophet, who's Muhammad, هذا
No, it's not him. But our Prophet ﷺ, whatever they say about him, doesn't go towards him. Alayhi salatu wasalam. Ala Sayyidina, our master, Muhammadin wa ala alihi. The word alihi, Shaykh al-Islam, al-Thani, Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyah. Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyah, he speaks about kalam, a statement, badi' which is amazing, muharrar fil muradi bi alihi. What's meant by the al? Ibn al-Qayyim has a powerful explanation on what it means. So if you go to his kitab, Jala'ul Afham fi fadli salati ala khayri al-alam, you go to Faslul Rabi', the chapter being Babu Thalith, you find that Ibn Rajab rahimahullah, he speaks about what is meant by al. But the qawl that yatma'inu ilayhi nafs is the qawl of Imam al-Shafi'i. This is the qawl, inshallah ta'ala, that the heart finds tranquility, is that the al is meant by who? That the al is meant by Bani Hashim, who the Prophet was from, and Bani Muttalib. Those are the two groups. And Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah stated that in his kitab al-Risala, and also in his kitab Jumma'ul Ilm. وَعَلَىٰ آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ صَحْبِهِ, as we said, is that is his companions. And the companion is what? مَنْ لَقِيَ النَّبِيَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مُؤْمِنًا بِهِ وَمَاتَ عَلَىٰ الْإِسْلَامِ وَلَوْ تَخَلَّلَتْ رِدَّتُهُ عَلَى الْأَصَحِ. Is anyone who met the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he died upon Islam? You see, even if there came a time where he apostated, but he did come back to Islam, you see, that person is what? Still a companion. Still a companion. وَبَعْدُ, to proceed. So we said the waw here, are you with me? Is a na'ibah. It's taking the place of amma. And amma is taking the place of what? مَهْمَا يَكُن مِنْ أَمْرٍ. So it's, what would we say? That the waw here right now is? Yeah? So it's a na'ibah of amma. And the amma is a na'ibah of what? So we call it na'ibatun na'ibah. But it's better to follow the prophetic sunnah. Because our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never used to say wabadu. And it's important that we try to follow him salawatullahi wa sallam alayhi in our speech, in our actions and everything. It's good to do that. So it's better to say amma ba'du, to proceed. فَهَذِهِ رِسَالَةٌ لَخَصْتُ فِيهَا الْخِصَالُ الْمُكَفِّرَةِ لِلذُّنُوبِ الْمُتَقَدِّمَةِ وَالْمُتَأَخِّرَةِ. The author says here, I have what? Summarized. لَخَصْتُ. I summarized. What did he summarize? This is a risala in which I have summarized al-khisal al-mukaffira. Carrot things, the khisal here are two types. The khisal here are two things. They are speeches and actions that a person can come with which will give him what? Al-mukaffirati lidhunub. That will expiate you for your sins. Al-mutaqaddima, that which is to come. Wal-mutaakhira, sorry, al-mutaqaddimati, that which has been passed, and then al-mutaakhirat, that which is to come. So the Shaykh here, rahimahullah, is going to bring in this risala, and this is what the book is about now, is that he's going to be speaking about al-khisal al-mukaffira. The khisal al-mukaffira is what? Al-af'al wal-aqwal. Speeches and actions. Al-mujibatu li-takfiri dhunubi, that will expiate us for our sins and our shortcomings. It would have been better if the author, instead of saying al-khisal al-mukaffirati lidhunubi al-mutaqaddimati wal-mutaakhira, it would have been better if he had said, and he called it, khisalul maghfirati lidhunubi al-mutaqaddimati wal-mutaakhira. And he didn't say mukaffira, and he used the word maghfira. Because as we're going to see later, the narrations that he's going to bring, the word that's used is maghfira. The wording that's going to be used is going to be غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمْ مِنْ ذَنْبِ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. So mukaffira, what would have been better is that he used the word maghfira instead of mukaffira. وَقَدْ أَلَّفَ الْحَافِظُ ابْنُ حَجَرٍ. And Ibn Hajar authored. Ibn Hajar, as we said, his name is what? Shihabuddin Ahmed ibn Ali ibn Hajar al-Asqalaniyu. He authored a book which he called مَعْرِفَةُ الْخِصَالِ الْمُكَفِّرَةِ لِلذُّنُوبِ الْمُتَقَدِّمَةِ وَالْمُتَأَخِّرَةِ. وَقَدْ أَلَّفَ الْحَافِظُ إِبْنُ حَجَرٍ كِتَابًا, a book, سَمَّاهُ, which he called it بِالْخِصَالِ الْمُكَفِّرَةِ لِلذُّنُوبِ الْمُتَقَدِّمَةِ وَالْمُتَأَخِّرَةِ وَقَدْ سَبَقَهُ إِلَى ذَلِكَ الْمُنْذِرِيُّ. And before Ibn Hajar, Al-Imam Al-Mundri came before him in this regard. Which is what? Zakiyuddin Abdul Azim Al-Mundri, the author of the Kitab Al-Targhib wa Al-Tarhib. He has a little risala which he called it Juz'un fi ahadithi maghfirati ma taqaddama wa ma ta'akhara min al-dhunub. So Al-Mundri is one's better in the naming because it has what? Juz' fi ahadithi maghfira. It doesn't say mukaffira. And as you all know, is that these letters, mukaffira, comes from this root word of kafara, right? Al-kafu wal-fa'u wal-ra. Ibn Faris, what does he say? Al-kafu wal-fa'u wal-ra aslun sahih. And where does it come from? What's the original root that it comes from? Al-satr wal-taghtiyah. It is to hide something. Sahih? You see, that is where it comes from. That's why the farmer is referred to as a kafir. The farmer is called a kafir. It's mufa'il. He's the one who does this. Al-muzari'u kafiran. لأنه يغطي البذرة. Because what he does is that he hides and he takes a seed and he places it in the earth. So this is what he's doing here right now is at-taghdi. He's covering it and he's hiding it in there. So this is called kufr. So these are characteristics which your sins will be what? It will be concealed for you. It will be what? Concealed for a person. And it will be hidden for them. That's what it is. وَقَدْ رَأَيْتُ أَنَّ السُّيُوطِ said, I saw أَنْ أُلَخِّصَ أَحَادِيثَهُ لِيُسْتَفَادَ. That I summarize the narrations so a person can benefit from it. وَقَدْ رَأَيْتُ I saw. He saw Ibn Hajar's book and he saw Al-Hafidh Al-Mundri's book and he thought to himself, okay, how about I summarize it? I summarize it. Why? لِيُسْتَفَادَ, so the people can benefit from it. And that's, mashallah, the concern that the ulama have for the ummah and the ummah's well-being. That they author things for us to benefit from. And it is also then upon us to benefit from those works of theirs. The first of the 16 is the narration he started with, which is أخرج ابن أبي شيبة في مسنده ومصنفه وأبو بكر المروزي في مسنده والبزار عن عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول لا يسبغ عبد الوضوء إلا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. This hadith is sound narration. It's a hadith which is what? It's a sound narration. It's a sound narration, which is that it's Hassan. And the wording that's being used here, which is وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ تَأَخَّرَ, that's used, وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ, is a ziyada which is shadha. Shadha mean that it's not authentic. It opposes the narrations of the thiqat, the scholars who are reliable. It goes against their narration. And as he mentioned right now, the reason for that shudud in this narration is, as Bazzar mentions in his Kashful Astar, that he says, وَلَا نَعْلَمُ أَسْنَدَ مُحَمَّدْ إِبْنُ كَعْبْ عَنْ حِمْرَانِ إِلَّا هَذَا. Al-Haythami, in his Mujma'u al-Zawaid wa Manba'u al-Fawaid, he said, رَوَاهُ Bazzar narrated this. وَرِجَالُهُ مَوْثُوقُونَ وَالْحَدِيثُ حَسَنٌ إِنْشَاءَ. Ibn Rajab says, إِسْنَادُهُ لَا بَأْسَ بِهِ. There's no problem with it. Hafiz ibn Hajar says, وَأَصْلُ الْحَدِيثِ فِي الصَّحِيحَيْنِ. Originally, this hadith is in Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim. في فضل الوضوء من طريق حمران عن عثمان من وجه ليس فيه شيء من منها زيادة وما تأخر. This wording, وما تأخر, is not in any of the ziyadat, any of the narrations. You see, you don't find that زيادة in it. وقال المنذري والإمام المنذري said, رواه البزار بإسناد حسن. Ibn Abi Shayba, as the author said, he narrated in his Musnad and his Musannaf, both. And this we took it, remember, in Kitab Umdatul Ahkam, right? That Uthman radiallahu anhu, he did the wudu for the people, and once he finished it, he said this. But in that narration, if you go back, because Umdatul Ahkam is the shurut of it is what? Mimma ittafaqa alayhi shaykhan. That which Bukhari and Muslim both agreed upon. So لا يسبغ عبد الوضوء. No slave. The word يسبغ means places the water fully over himself. He does it correctly, makes sure every limbs has its rights given to it. In its ablution, if a person does that, what will he receive in return? غفر له, he will be forgiven. ما تقدم من ذنبه, the past sins. And the things that he has done in the past, it will be forgiven for him. As for وما تأخر, we said that is a ziyada, which is shadha, and it goes against ما في الصحيحين. And we also, you always have to remember the riwayat that go against صحيحين in ziyadat, you really need to always try to make sure that you double check. لأن الأئمة الإمامين البخاري and Muslim, both of them, their only job and their concern was what? الصحة, authenticity. They are the only two ulama whose siha and tadqiq and tahqiq of narrations have been fully agreed upon. لذلك الشيخ الصالح ابن عبد الله العصيمي has a sharh of this particular book that we're going through. He says the following, which I'm going to read on you. He says, فَيَنْبَغِي, it is necessary, أَنْ يَتَوَقَّى طَالِبُ الْعِلْمِ قَبُولَ زِيَادَةِ عَمَّا جَاءَ فِي الصَّحِحَيْنِ. That is, he said it's necessary that a student of knowledge, he's diligent and he's also vigilant in accepting ziyadat, extra wordings that have come over what is the Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim. وكما يكون هذا في ألفاظ الأحاديث فإنه يشبه أن يكون في الأحاديث نفسها مما يكون أصلا في الباب. So this is the point that the Sheikh says that I wanted to mention. That the person is concerned in knowing that whatever you find that is additional to what is in Bukhari and Muslim, that you have to give a look to it and verify and check. A lot of the times it's not with them. نعم. Hadith number two. أخرج أبو عوانة الإمام أبو عوانة رحمه الله he brought في صحيحه إن الصحيح نعم عن سعيد بن أبي وقاص رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قال حين يسمع المؤذن أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا وفي لفظ ورسولا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. This hadith, as we said, or as we mentioned in our previous hadith, the first one, which Uthman's hadith, رضي الله تعالى عنه, this hadith is the same. It's a sound hadith. It's a hasan hadith. It's a hadith which is, it's Hassan. And Abu Awana al-Isfrayini rahimahullah, he brought it in his what? His mustakhraj ala sahih Muslim. That's what he brought it in. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, man qala, anyone who says, hina yasma'u al-mu'adhin, when he hears the mu'adhin, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, I testify that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. رَضِيْتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبًّا, I am pleased with Allah as my Lord. وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا, and I am also pleased with Islam as my religion. وَبِمُحَمَّدٍ نَبِيًّا, وَبِمُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ نَبِيًّا, and I am also pleased with Muhammad as my prophet. وَفِي لَفْظٍ, in another wording, it says رَسُولًا, as my messenger. Anyone who says that after they have heard the adhan, غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ, he is forgiven for his past sins, وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ, and that which is to come. This is the same with this narration as well, that the ziyada is also not accepted. It's a ziyada which is غير صحيحة. Ibn Salah rahimahullah mentions, وهي زيادة ليس بالصحيحة. It is an additional adding which is not authentic. It's not accepted. So now the question that arises is that when does the person say this statement? رضيت بالله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا. When does the person say this? Al-Shaykh Salih, Ibn Abdullah al-Usaymi, he says, وَاخْتَلَفَ الْعُلَمَاءِ رَحِمَهُمُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فِي مَوْقِعِ هَذَا الذِّكْرِ مِنَ الْأَذَانِ عَلَىٰ أَقْوَالٍ. The scholars, they differed amongst themselves when this adhan should be, when should this dua be made, when should it be said. And then he chose the strongest of it all. He says, الصحوحة, the strongest is that أن العبد يأتي به بعد قول المؤذن. He comes with it when the Imam says after the أشهد أن محمد رسول الله the second time. So when when the مؤذن says أشهد أن محمد رسول الله, أشهد أن محمد رسول الله, then the person says it. Once he finishes saying that, the listener, he says his dua. So that is the strongest that the Shaykh rahimahullah chose. Okay. أخرج ابن وهب في مصنفه عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إذا أمن الإمام فأمنوا فإن الملائكة تؤمن فمن وافق تأمينه تأمين الملائكة غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. This hadith is, as you can see, narrated by Ibn Wahb rahimahullah. And Imam Ibn Wahb rahimahullah, he brought this narration in his what? He brought this narration in his Musannaf. He brought it in his Musannaf, rahimahullah ta'ala. That the Messenger alayhi salatu was salam, he says, سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم say, حديث أبو هريرة, إذا أمن الإمام, when the Imam says the آمين, فأمنوا, say the آمين with him, فإن الملائكة تؤمنوا, for verily the angels, they do the آمين, فمن وافق تأمينه تأمين الملائكة, فمن وافق تأمينه تأمين الملائكة, anyone who's آمين and the آمين of the gets, anyone who's آمين is in correlation with the آمين of the angels, غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه, his past sins are forgiven for him. وما تأخر is a ziyada, which is not accepted. Because it's what? Because the asal of this hadith is Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim. ليست فيه هذه الزيادة. This ziyada, it's not in it. It's not in it. Very good. And Hafiz ibn Hajar, if you look at Fath al-Bari, Hafiz ibn Hajar, if you look at Fath al-Bari, he says تنبيه ذكر الغزالي في الوسيط وفي الوجيز زيادة ما تقدم من ذنبي وما تأخر. And he mentions that this ziyada from him and Ibn Salah is a ziyada which is shadha. Hafiz ibn Hajar. Ibn Wahb is who? Abdullah ibn Wahb al-Misri. His Musannaf is not published yet. Some of it has been published from his Jami', and some of it, his Muwatta is also published, some of it. As for his Musannaf, لم يطبع بعد. He hasn't been published yet. أخرج ابن آدم ابن أبي إياس في كتاب الثواب عن علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى سجدة الضحى ركعتين إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ذنوبه كلها ما تقدم منها وما تأخر إلا القصاص. This hadith لا يصح إسناده. Its إسناد is not accepted. This narration is not accepted. Hafiz ibn Hajar, he said إسناده ضعيف جدا. The chain of narration of it is very weak. Al-Imam al-Khattab, he said, قال الحطاب الحطاب sorry, he said وأصل الحديث في سنن الترمذي وابن ماجة من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من حافظ على شفعة على شفعة الضحى غفرت له ذنوبه وإن كان مثل زبد البحر. The asal is in Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah. As for this narration, is weak. As for the statement that I deliberately didn't want to say, is that Al-Imam As-Suyuti rahimahullah, what did he say? He said, أخرج ابن أبي ياسين. He said, أخرج آدم ابن أبي ياسين في كتاب الثواب عن علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله تعالى عنه. He didn't say رضي الله عنه. He said, كرم الله وجهه. Is that what it says? So here we say that him specifying Ali with كرم الله وجهه, this is مما لا يحمد. It's not praiseworthy. Because it's something that creeped in by the Rafidah, the Shia. They specifically want to say for Ali something unique. That we don't deny, we want Allah to honor the face of Ali ibn Abi Talib. Huh? But to specify Ali with it, when you just mention Abu Hurairah, when you mention other companions, this is what something that Ibn Kathir did not accept in his tafsir. Ibn Kathir. Also the wording that's been used here, which is Man Salla Sajdata Duha. This wording, what is well known and transmitted from the scholars of hadith is that Man Salla Subhata Duha. So Subhata Duha is used, not Sajdata Duha. So maybe it could be, Allahu A'lam, it could be a tasheef. It could be. Anybody who prays Salatu Duha Rak'atayn, and he prays it Imanan Wahtisaba, the Prophet said. Or it's said that the Prophet said. We say, غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ, that he will be forgiven for his past sins and that which is to come. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he mentions that this narration is not transmitted from the Prophet authentically. But what is known is إِنَّمَا وَقَعَتْ فِي كَلَامِ الصَّحَابَةِ فَمَنْ بَعْدَهُمْ. This is a statement that has come from the companions, those to come after. As for the virtues of Salatul Duha and the virtues pertaining to it, then there's books written on it. Al-Imam Abu Abdullah al-Hakim al-Naysaburi, he has a book called Kitab Salatul Duha, which he mentions in it a hadith, many of them, with their chains of narrations. Even Kitab Zad al-Ma'ad fi Hadi Khayr al-Ibad by Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyah, he has chapters where he speaks about it. غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ إِلَّا الْقِصَاصَ, except qisas. Except what? إِلَّا الْقِصَاصَ. Naam. The reason why qisas has been said here in this narration, or the hadith says it, is because the qisas is a right of the creation on you. It's a huququl المخلوقين. And as the Sharia deals with is that you have to clear yourself from the rights of the creation as well. Because the حقوق are حقوق الله, the rights of Allah تبارك وتعالى محضة, they're only His rights. And there's حقوق which are مشترك, they're Allah's rights and the rights of the creation. The creation doesn't have His rights only. Whenever you wrong the creation, you also wrong Allah تبارك وتعالى. So by coming with these actions, it expiates for you the rights of Allah. Allah will forgive you regarding it. As for the creation, you also have to get the forgiveness from them. Naam. So the rights of the creation doesn't drop from you like that. وَأَخْرَجَ أَبُو سَعَدٍ أَلْقُشَيْرِيُّ فِي الْأَرْبَعِينَ عَنْ أَنَسٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ قَالَ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مَنْ قَرَأَ إِذَا سَلَّمَ الْإِمَامُ يَوْمَ الْجُمْعَةِ قبل أن يثني رجليه فاتحة الكتاب وقل هو الله أحد وقل أعوذ برب الفلق وقل أعوذ برب الناس سبعا سبعا غفر له ما تقدم وما تأخر. This narration is weak, ضعيف. This narration is weak. It's a weak narration. It's a weak narration. Sheikh Al-Albani rahimahullah in Da'if al-Jami', he actually even said that it's fabricated. Hafidh ibn Hajar, he said, فِي إِسْنَادِهِ ضَعْفٌ شَدِيدٌ جِدًّا. Its narration is excessively weak. He says that. This narration It says أخرج أبو سعد. That's what it says, right? This is what's in the نسخة خطية, the original copy. That's what you find in it. And this may be a mistake from the ناسخ, the one who wrote the book, because the name is not أبو سعد. The correct name is what? أبو الأسعد is the correct name. أبو الأسعد. If you look at the مصادر and the ترجمة of the author, this is the name is أبو الأسعد and not, and it is not أبو سعد القشيري. He said that Anas ibn Malik said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said من قرأ إذا سلم الإمام, whoever recites when the Imam says the salam, يوم الجمعة, the day of جمعة, قبل أن يثني رجليه, before he opens his legs. Before he opens his legs, meaning he moves from his position, that's what it means. فاتحة الكتاب, he reads سورة الفاتحة, and then he reads سورة الإخلاص, and then he reads سورة الفلق, and then he reads سورة الناس, seven each. غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه, he's forgiven for his past sins and the upcoming sins. He's forgiven for it, and expiated for it. He said this narration is what? This narration is weak, and this one we can't implement because it's a legislation. Okay, it's a legislation, so this one there's no implementation for it. وأخرج أحمد عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. This narration and the narration to come and the one to come, I'm going to read because they're all the same. وأخرج أحمد عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. وأخرج النسائي في الكبير وقاسم بن الأصبغ في مصنفه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر ومن قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. These three hadiths that are all narrated from Abu Huraira is originally in Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim. It's all in what? They're all in Bukhari and they are all in Bukhari and Muslim. You'll find it there. And there's none of them in Bukhari and Muslim. Never does it say the wording وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. So we say this is a ziyada شَاذَةٌ لَا تَثْبُتُ. It's a ziyada which is شَاذ. And شَاذ is from the types which a narration is rejected for, right? So it's not accepted. What is sahih is that the forgiveness is only for the previous sins. في ذكر مغفرة الذنوب المتقدمة, the past sins. As for the upcoming sins, there is no evidence for them. وأخرج النسائي في الكبير, he says, right? This is وأخرج النسائي في الكبير. الشيخ صالح بن عبد الله بن حمد العصيمي brings a فائدة which he says, يعني في سنن في سننه الكبرى. الإمام النسائي has two books, right? He has a صغرى and he has a كبرى. So صالح بن عبد الله العصيمي points out, إذ يقال لها السنن الكبير وسنن الكبرى. So some scholars, they call it سنن الكبير. Some call it سنن الكبرى. ويقال كذلك في كتاب البيهقي السنن الكبير والسنن الكبرى. Also Bayhaqi's kitab is also called, الإمام البيهقي is a sunan, right? So it's also called سنن الكبير and سنن الكبرى. وسنن النسائي الكبرى, the Sunan Nasa'i, which is Kubra, is the one that Imam Nasa'i referred to as Kitab al-Sunan. The other book of his, Imam Nasa'i, the Sughra, is called Al-Mujtaba min al-Sunan al-Musnadati. Are you with me? The Mujtaba is the Sughra. It's called Al-Mujtaba min al-Sunan al-Musnadati. Then, because it became the first one was called Sunan al-Kubra, the scholars started to refer to the Mujtaba as a Sughra. ثم غلب عند أهل العلم التفريق بينهما بجعل الصغرى لقبا كتاب المجتبى وجعل الكبرى لقبا بكتاب السنن. نعم. All these narrations, what they show is that the Prophet ﷺ says, anyone who fasts the month of Ramadan with iman and ihtisab, with belief of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and hoping reward from him, that person will be forgiven for their past sins. Also, the person who fasts the month of Ramadan with iman and ihtisab, he will be forgiven for his what? His past sins. Also, the person who stands up the month of Ramadan, Laylatul Qadr, anyone who stands up in the month of the month of Ramadan and Laylatul Qadr with iman and ihtisab, that they are forgiven for their past sins. As for to come sins, there's no narration which is authentic in that. وأخرج أبو داود والبيهقي في الشعب عن أبي عن أم سلمة رضي الله تعالى عنها أنها سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من أهل بحجة أو عمرة من المسجد الأقصى إلى المسجد الحرام غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر ووجبت له الجنة. This narration, which is narrated by Abu Dawood and Al-Bayhaqi. Abu Dawood and Al-Bayhaqi. Al-Bayhaqi brought it in Kitab Shu'ab al-Iman. Al-Imam Abu Dawood, he brought it in his what? In his Sunan Kitab al-Manasik, Bab al-Muwaqit. Al-Bani rahimahullah weakened it in his Da'if al-Jami', and he also weakened it in his Takhrij that he done on Sunan Abi Dawood. Bayhaqi brought it in his Shu'ab al-Iman. Sheikh Al-Bani also weakened it in his Silsila Hadith al-Da'ifa. That this Hadith in Shu'ab al-Iman, that the Prophet ﷺ said, they said, يَمَنْ أَهَلَّ بِحَجَّةٍ, anyone who goes to Hajj, أو عُمْرَةٍ مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْأَقْصَى, from the Masjid al-Aqsa, إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ, to Masjid al-Haram, he will be forgiven, مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ وَمَا تَأَخَرَ, his past sins and his upcoming sins. وَوَجَّبَتْ لَهُ الْجَنَّةِ, and Jannah has been promised to him. This Hadith is weak. As I said, in terms of its chain is weak. What is also not acceptable from this narration is the fact that it says that the person has to do his, or the person doing his Hajj and Umrah from Bayt al-Maqdis, from Bayt al-Aqsa, a Masjid al-Aqsa. And this goes against the narrations that state the Mawaqit, the places, the Mawaqit al-Makaniyah, that the Sharia has put down. It goes against it. It goes against it. نعم. عشيق صالح ابن عبد الله العصيمي, he says هذا الحديث إسناده ضعيف ولم يثبت شيء من الأحاديث المتضمنة مدح الإهلال بالنسك قبل ميقاته. That there is no narration that gives virtue to what? Doing your إحرام before your ميقات. Okay? There's no narrations. But وإنما ثبت ذلك عن بعض الصحابة. Some of the companions did say so, لكن كابن عمر, Abdullah ibn Umar, as it's narrated by Abdul Razak ibn Hammam al-San'ani in his Musannaf. In the second volume, in his Amali. So this he says that مما يدل على جواز, it is permissible to do your ihram from before the miqat. You're allowed to do that. And he goes, this goes against the statement of the scholars who saw it to be makruh, or who saw it to be haram from the mutaqaddimin and from the mutaakhirin. So he says, فالإهلال بالنسك قبل الميقات, doing your wearing your ihram and everything before the miqat is jaizun, is permissible. والسنة أن يهل من ميقات بلده الذي وقت له شرعا. So it is permissible for the person from outside the miqat, from their land in which they are coming from, for them to do the ihlal, it is permissible for them shara'an, through the sharia. Number 10. أخرج أبو نعيم في الحلية عن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من جاء حاجا يريد وجه الله تعالى غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. This narration, Abu Nu'aym al-Asfahani, both ways could be said, he brought in his kitab Hilyatul Awliya wa Tabaqatul Asfiya. That's the name of the book. That's the name of the book. And the book is a very well-known book. This hadith this name you have to remember, when they say it, the scholars they say Abu Nu'aym, they always mean like this, the itlaqiha. Abu Nu'aym is always meant by, generally like that, is meant by Abu Nu'aym al-Asfahani, Abu al-Asfahani. But there are other scholars who are called Abu Nu'aym, like Abu Nu'aym Fadl ibn Dukayn, who's Shaykh al-Bukhari. He's called it. But that's not meant by it. When the scholars they say Abu Nu'aym, they mean by Al-Imam Abu Nu'aym al-Asfahani, Abu al-Asfahani, they mean it by him. So you have to always try to know as a student of knowledge, Itlaqatul Asma', when names are unrestrictedly said, who is it generally well known, like Sufyan, when it's said, is it Thawri or is it Ibn Uyayna, who's the Asal that the Sufyan is meant by? Scholars have written books on this. So Talib al-Ilm, student of knowledge, should try to learn those names and have understanding. أخرج أبو نعيم في الحلية عن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه قال I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم say it. But this hadith as we said is إسناده ضعيف. Its chain of narration is what? Its chain of narration is weak. حافظ بن حجر weakened in his معرفة الخصال. Very good. من جاء حاجا يريد وجه الله غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. That a person who comes Hajj wanting Allah's face, he's doing only for Allah's sake, he will be forgiven for his past sins and that which is to come. Hadith number 11. أخرج أحمد ابن منيع وأبو يعلى في مسنديهما عن جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قضى نسكه وسلم المسلمون من لسانه ومن يده غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. أحمد بن منيع and Abu Ya'la, both of them narrated in their musnads. They all both narrated in their musnads. من حديث جابر that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said. So this narration again is إسناده ضعيف. Its chain of narration is what? Its chain of narration is what? Is weak. His chain of narration is weak. Al-Hafidh ibn Hajr speaks about it in his Matalib al-Aliyah. Al-Busiri says, Rawahu Ahmad ibn Mani' wal-Lafdhu lahu wa Abdullah ibn Humayd wa Abu Bakr ibn Abi Shaybah wa Abu Ya'la. You can find it in the Ittihaf al-Mihara. Man qada nusukahu. Anybody who finished, what it means is man qada nusukahu. It means man faragha min adai hajji. Anyone who finishes doing his hajj. وسلم المسلمون and the Muslims they find safety من لسانه from his tongue. He doesn't harm the Muslims by verbally insulting them. ومن يده and he also finds safety, the Muslims physically find safety from him. He doesn't physically harm them. غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. His past and his upcoming sins are all forgiven. He's forgiven for all of them. So this narration is, as we said, is weak. But scholars have written books on the virtue, a hadith which are sahiha, on the virtues of Hajj al-Mabrur. An accepted Hajj and the conditions for a Hajj which is accepted, scholars have written books on it. So you'd find those narrations which are sahih over there. Na'am. Number 12. أخرج الثعلبي في التفسير عن أنس رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قرأ آخر سورة الحشر غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. This narration is also weak. And Tha'labi, he is the author of a tafsir book which he has. He has a book, a tafsir book, which he brings asanid and chains of narrations for. And we have to try to know the difference between a Tha'labi and a Tha'alibi. Okay? His book is called Kashful Wal Bayan. As for Al-Tha'alibi, who authored the tafsir, he's a latecomer. He's a mutaakhir who has come recently. As for Al-Tha'alibi's book, his narrations are musnada, chains. As for Al-Tha'alibi's tafsir book, it contains some ahadith which are musnada and ahadith which are not musnada. Very good. And we said this narration is what? This narration is weak. This narration is weak. Hafidh ibn Hajar said, in it is who? Fihi Yazid ibn Aban al-Raqqash is in it. And he's a weak person. Wa Muhammad ibn Yunus. And there's a lot of speech regarding him as well. Scholars have said about him. So that's where the weakness is in this narration for. Anyone who recites, it says, man qara'a akhira surat al-hashri. Anyone who reads the last part of Surah Al-Hashri, he's going to be forgiven for his past sins and his upcoming sins. أخرج عبد الله بن مندة في أماليه عن ابن عمر رضي الله تعالى عنهما قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قاد مكفوفا 40 خطوة غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. عبد الله بن مندة he narrates in his أماليه. The strongest opinion is that, or the correction needs to be done here, which is that Abdullah ibn Manda is not right. The name is not Abdullah ibn Manda. The name should be what? Abu Abdullah ibn Manda. And that's how it fell in the book Tanwir wal Hawalik, as Abdullah Sheikh Salih ibn Abdullah al-Usaymi pointed out. So it should be Akhrajahu Abu Abdullah ibn Manda. And the chain of narration for this hadith is weak. It has been narrated in many different forms, wujuh mutaaddida, from many different angles. لا يثبت منها شيء. There's no correct version for it. من قاد مكفوفاً. مكفوفاً is a blind person. So anybody who leads a blind person, grabs him by the arm, leg, and takes him to a place, a masjid, or he leads him, wherever it may be, guides him and grabs him by the arm. But 40 خطوة, 40 steps. غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. You will be forgiven for your past sins and your upcoming sins. The reason why makfufan is named, the blind is called a makfuf, is because لأنه بصره كفى, because his eyesight is gone. It's been blocked. فغطي عن رؤية ما يريد. Can't see what he wants. That is why it's called مكفوف. وأخرج أحمد بن ناصح في فوائده. أحمد بن ناصح narrated in his فوائد عن ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said it shouldn't be Ahmed ibn Nasih. It should be Abu Ahmed ibn Nasih. عن ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من سعى لأخيه في حاجة. Any person who strives in the support and the help of his brother, غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. Your past and your upcoming sins are forgiven for you. This hadith is ضعيف. لا يثبت أيضا. This hadith is also weak. It is not authentic. It is not authentic. نعم. Number 15. وأخرج أبو الحسين عن سفيان وأبو يعلى في مسنديهما عن أنس رضي الله تعالى عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ما من عبدين يلتقيان فيتصافحان ويصليان على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إلا لم يتفرقا حتى يغفر لهما ذنوبهما ما تقدم منها وما تأخر. This narration is weak. This narration is also weak. As for what the narration says is that there's no two slaves who meet one another and they shake each other's hands and they send salutation on the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام except and they depart one another except that they are forgiven for their past sin and their upcoming sins. Okay? This hadith is weak, as we said. And al-musafaha inda al-liqa, when you meet one another, to shake each other's hands, and wuqu'u al-maghfirati fiha, and receiving forgiveness for that. There are many ahadith that have come in regarding that. So there's no debate about that. Na'am. But as for this particular narration, isnaduhu da'if, its chain of narration is what? Is weak. And the reason why the narration is weak is because of Ahmed ibn Bakar. Ibn Habban mentions him in his thaqat, and he says, يخطئ, he makes mistakes. وضعفه ابن عدي, ابن عدي weakens him. Rather, Abu al-Fath al-Azdi, he said that he criticized him for being a person who fabricates narrations. Daraqutni, he said, rahimahullah, غيره أثبت منه, other than him are stronger. So other scholars are stronger. Leave him alone. The last narration, which is وأخرج أبو داود عن معاذ بن جبل. معاذ is a صحابي جليل, a noble companion. You see, here it doesn't say معاذ بن جبل on some of the nusakhs. Some of the nusakhs, they say معاذ بن أنس. That's wrong. It's معاذ بن جبل. أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, that the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من أكل طعاما ثم قال, anyone who eats a food and he says, الحمد لله الذي أطعمني هذا الطعام ورزقنيه من غير حول مني ولا قوة. Anyone who says this, الحمد لله, praises to Allah, الذي أطعمني, the one who provided for me, هذا الطعام, this food, ورزقنيه, and he provided me, من غير حول مني ولا قوة. It wasn't my hard work and my efforts that I brought this with. No one does this. غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه, he is forgiven for his past sins, وما تأخر, and that which is to come. ومن لبس ثوبا جديدا, and anyone who dresses with a new clothing, فقال, and then he says, الحمد لله الذي كساني هذا, the one who clothed me with this, من غير حول مني ولا قوة, it's not my hard work and my effort and my strength in which I brought myself this, rather it's from you, Allah. ولا قوة, غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. This person is what? Is forgiven for their past sin and their upcoming sin. This narration, which is the last one, Abu Dawood narrated it also in his Kitab, in his Sunan. Scholars have disagreed on its authentication and whatnot. Al-Sheikh Salih ibn Abdullah al-Usaymi, he took the opinion that it's weak, but our heart is content with what Hafiz ibn Hajar said, rahimahullah, which is إسناده حسن, that the chain of narration of this hadith is حسن. As for the wording وما تأخر, Abu Dawood didn't mention that wording وما تأخر in his Sunan. So whether it's shad or not, it would be needed to be looked into more. وقد تخلص من هذه الأحاديث 16 خصلة. So here we, inshallah ta'ala, we had finished 16 characteristics. We finished 16 what? 16 narrations of things that a person can come with, whether it be speeches, whether it be action. Whether it becomes actions. And as we saw, the word khasala, the plural of the, it's a plural of what? Khisal. And khisal is a fadilatun wa radhila. It is something that is a characteristic which is either good or bad that can be present in a person. But the majority of the time, the scholars, they use it for that which is good. So we mentioned 16 of them. Walhamdulillah, praises to Allah, ala in'amihi wa ifdalihi dhalika fadlullahi yu'tihi man yasha. And Allah is praised, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in blessing and bestowing His virtue onto us. ذلك فضل الله, this is the virtue of Allah, يؤتيه من يشاء, Allah gives it to whoever He wills, والله ذو الفضل العظيم, and Allah's virtue is great and large. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. Anything which I have said that was wrong, and it was a mistake. فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ It's from me as shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ